Yes. Yeah. Ma'am, don't do that. Please. Please. Terrible.
This is our property and we have a permit to be here. Please stop.
Stop. Hey, what's that sound? All the fetuses are in the ground. Look, there's mine right there.
This year, all across America, student rights have been violated. Their educational displays torn down or vandalized, and their opinions silenced, simply because they are pro-life, anti-abortion. Those who advocate for abortion have been very clear about their intended goal, to mock, silence, or cancel any opinion they disagree with. But they don't know students for life. They don't get this pro-life generation. Because we know when one of us is under attack, all of us are. So for the last 13 years, at Students for Life, we've been standing together, united and determined, because we know that we all share and have a unique part to play in this mission, making abortion illegal and unthinkable. But what happened this year on our nation's campuses is sadly nothing compared to what we believe is coming. 2020 is almost here. And many believe we are only one Supreme Court justice away from having enough votes to reverse Roe v. Wade and Doe v. Bolton, sending the decision of abortion legalization back to each and every state. And those extremists who advocate for abortion for any reason, for the violent destruction of persons weaker and smaller than themselves, are preparing for something big. But so are we. At Students for Life, we are preparing for our destiny. Our destiny to become the first post-Roe generation. And we're ready to begin working state by state to pass laws making abortion a thing of the past, to create campus cultures to ensure that no woman ever feels like she has to choose between her education and the life of her child, to educate our friends and family in our nation about how abortion never solves any problems, but just uses violence to assert oppression onto others. But we aren't just waiting for this day to come. We've already started embarking on our mission.
Young women from the group Students United for Planned Parenthood stood in the middle of our crosses, yelling horrendous chants and claiming the crosses as their own abortions. They disrupted our outreach and our reserve space, and campus police did nothing to stop it. Despite their ugly display, our dialoguing only continued and grew. After we were protested, we had a sense of accomplishment and courage, because no matter the persecution, we knew the culture of life was being made known on campus.
When I tried to start a pro-life club on my campus, the high school refused to approve it. And if any teachers were to help, they were threatened to be fired. With the help of Students for Life and Alliance Defending Freedom, we threatened to sue my high school. And thanks to them, we were finally able to start our pro-life club, and our first event was Thursday, December 5th.
I helped a young mother who approached me to tell me that she had scheduled an abortion at Planned Parenthood. I was able to point her to the resources and the support that she needed to empower her to choose life for her baby. And now I've seen pictures of her baby, and now she's getting the support that she needs to go back to school while being a mother.
My pro-life group at Liberty University has held more than 1,133 conversations about abortion on campus this semester through Students for Life's Talk Initiative. Our club was the first in the country to reach 250 conversations for Talk.
I helped to host more than 8 lobby days at my state capitol and recruit dozens of student and adult grassroots activists to join me and my Students for Life young adult group, Fresno Pro-Life Future, against an extreme law that forces universities in California to dispense the abortion pill on campus.
This last election, I made 1,500 phone calls and sent out 40,000 text messages to voters in Virginia. I was part of the team that made 65,000 phone calls, knocked on 15,000 doors, and sent 875,000 text messages this election. My effort alongside Students for Life Action helped re-elect a pro-life hero to the Virginia legislature.
I assume most, if not all of you, have seen the videos of what took place at the Lincoln Memorial of our school being attacked by the mainstream media. After the full video was released, exonerating us of any wrongdoing, people's opinions started to change and support came flooding in. we decided that because we took attention away from the pro-life cause at the march, we should use our newfound platform to give back to that very cause. This is when we created the GoFundMe for this amazing organization. We thought this GoFundMe was the best way to bring attention and support to this organization who have made it their mission to fight for the lives of those who cannot do so themselves.
While the extremists who advocate for abortion ramp up their efforts to silence and shut down pro-life students out of fear that Roe will soon be no more, we will choose to carry on our mission in love and with hope and joy. In love for both mother and her child. With hope that we will be able to tell our children that we played a part in abolishing abortion. And with joy, because we know we are standing on the right side of history for human rights. So join us in 2020. Stand united with us and play your part to help us fulfill our destiny of becoming the first post-Roe generation. What are you waiting for?